Hello guys, good morning. I'm here to present my presentation, chapter 8, about sampling methods and the central limit theorem. Study case about chat time. The topic of discussion is sampling methods. Sampling in statistics refers to the process of selecting a subset of individuals or units from a larger population to estimate characteristics of the population. Sampling is an essential aspect of statistical inference because it is usually impractical or impossible to measure every individual in a population. There are many different methods of sampling, but they all involve selecting a smaller group of individuals from a larger population in a systematic or random way. Common sampling methods include simple random sampling, stratified sampling, cluster sampling, and systematic sampling. Each method has its own advantage and disadvantage, and the choice of method will depend on the specific research question and the characteristic of the population being studied. The sampling methods. First, simple random sampling. Simple random sample is a sample selected so that each item or person in the population has the same chance of being included. Second is systematic random sampling. A random starting point is selected, and then every member of the population is selected. Third is stratified random sampling. A population is divided into subgroups called strata, and a sample is randomly selected from each stratum. Fourth is cluster sampling. A population is divided into clusters using naturally occurring geographic or other boundaries. Then, clusters are randomly selected, and a sample is collected by randomly selecting from each clusters. Next, sampling errors. Sampling error, the difference between a sample statistic and its corresponding population parameter. Sampling is used to calculate the sample or estimation of population parameters. The site process is not always smooth. The difference between the sampling statistic and the population parameter, sampling errors. Here is the symbol. First, parameter name, number of cases, the population parameter symbol is N. The sample statistic is N. Next, parameter name, mean, population parameter symbol is mu. Sample statistic is X bar or sample mean. Proportion from the parameter name, population parameter symbol is pi. Sample statistic is p or sample proportion. Parameter name, variance, population parameter symbol is sigma square. Sample statistic is sample variance. Parameter name, standard deviation, population parameter symbol is sigma. Sample statistic is sample standard deviation. Next, sampling distribution of the sample mean. A collection of probability distribution that contains all possible samples, which means the sample sizes is selected from the population. The mean of the distribution of sample means will be exactly equal to the population mean if we are able to select all possible samples of the same size from a given population. Summaries, the probability of sampling errors is X bar minus mu. Mean of the sample distribution mean is population mean. Here is the sampling distribution of the sample mean curve. Next, Here are the study cases. First, simple random sampling. Chatime has 7 menu, and their newest drink is hazelnut. To measure customer satisfaction, they survey the first 50 buyers and 10 random people with a similar level of satisfaction will be searched with the purpose of putting the drink on the Chatime favorites menu. Next is systematic random sampling. Chatime holds a giveaway and there are 30 participants who register themselves in the giveaway. To find out who will win, the committee will take 5 samples from them randomly. Then each element of the sample will be marked with serial numbers starting from 1 to 30. With this number, we can determine the distance, the interval from sample 1 and other sample is by using K is N divided by N. K is interval distance, N is population size, and N, the other N is number of samples. With the formula above, the interval distance in the research example is K is 30 divided by 5 is 6. So 6 will become the interval distance for sampling. Next is stratified random sampling. Chatime has a workforce of 1,000 employees with 600 working in administration and 400 working in production. The company wants to conduct a job satisfaction survey and it wants to ensure that the sample consists of both groups. If the company wants to survey 150 employees in total, how many should be surveyed from each group using stratified random sampling? The solution is, first, we need to determine the sample size from each group based on the proportion of employees in each group. Sample size from administration group is 150 times 600 divided by 1,000 is 90 employees. The next one is sample size from production group is 150 times 400 divided by 1,000. And the answer is 60 employees. Therefore, the company should survey 90 employees from the administration group and 60 employees from the production group to obtain a stratified random sample of 150 employees. Next, cluster sampling. Suppose Chatime wants to survey 50 college students in the target market, but with very few workers to do the survey, Chatime only select 2 faculty out of 5. So K is 2. Assume the faculty as a population of 2,000 college students. The total population size of college students in the target market is 10,000. Using the formula for cluster sampling, the sample size for each cluster can be calculated as N for N K divided by N times N K divided by K. Next is becomes 2,000 divided by 10,000 times 50 divided by 2. And the answer is 20. Therefore, the company should randomly select 2 faculty and survey 20 college students in each faculty to obtain a cluster sample of 40 college students. Thank you.